Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So, Mr. Henson, you were just talking about we should make the information available where Mr. Krebs could go out and find the rare earth mineral sites, right? 11 of them are in New Mexico. They shut down. The jobs are in China now. So just, if you want to come, Mr. Krebs, we'll drive you out there to them. The flags are still on the ground, and the jobs are gone. And by the way, the Chinese started charging 35% excise tax on the rare earth minerals because they want to now put our manufacturers out of business. Since they have the mining in their country, they want to put our manufacturers out of business for these strategic resources. And Ms. Pagel said they're getting an unfair deal. I don't know. It's hard to rectify that. What sort of rate of return do you make on your silver mines, Mr. Krebs? Your gross income.
It depends on what the price of silver is, obviously.
Today, what are you getting today, roughly?
Today, a rate of return on a new mine?
No, just your gross income.
Oh, on a gross income, we make cash flow of a couple $100 million a year. Then we pay about.
What percent is that?
That's about 15%.
15%. And what comes out after you pay, after you get gross income on the tax reforms? What comes out after gross income? What do you take out of that?
So after all the capital expenditures that we're required to make to continue operating, this year will be a
gross income doesn't include taxes, does it? Gross, that's net income to move. Mr. Kress, you seem to know a little bit about this. So you're going to move from gross income to net income. What are the deductions out of that, Mr. Kress? Mr. Kress?
I'm sorry. I'm not sure for his company.
No, I'm just talking in general. If you're going to move from gross income to net income.
Yes, you're going to have taxes. You're going to have depreciation. You're going to have depletion.
So really, when Ms. Pagel mentions 15% gross income, it's a little bit tricky because taxes come out after that, payroll taxes, any other taxes, any taxes to the state, any taxes to other countries come out after that. And so this quoting of 15% gross income is, I think, misleading at best. Now, again, reading Ms. Pagel's testimony, she says that more than half the delays, majority of the delays are up to you. So your 19 years, she would assert that 9.5 years plus were due to your actions. Can you document that to be a correct statement or an incorrect statement?
It's a little bit of a chicken and the egg, because every time there are lawsuits filed that delay things and for long enough, inevitably the price, the economics change. So then we're forced to go back and relook at what can actually be an economic approach to mining the resource. So then we have to start over, then that gets litigated. So whether that's on us for changing the plan or if it's we're changing the plan because we're delayed, I think it's the latter.
Yeah. So again, maybe there's a more complex argument to be made than just that you're out there changing plans randomly.
Yeah, we would prefer to not do that if we didn't have to.
So again, the assertion was made that you dumped 200,000 tons or gallons or something. 200,000 is a number that jumps out of the testimony into Slate Lake, Lower Slate Lake. Do you do that?
We have a tailings facility there that we contain that material, we treat it, and release it at standards that are set by the state of Alaska, which are among the highest in the country.
So you're not going to put 4.5 million tons of solids into the lake?
The solids go into the lake, okay. But that's ultimately what will form the base of this much larger lake that we'll have. That'll be a much, much healthier body of water by the end of the mine life.
All right. Mr. Kress, if the potash industry is one of the few mining industries still in New Mexico, and we've got a significant potash, what would happen to those jobs if we had an 8 to 12% royalty increase in potash?
Every mine would close. I've worked in that industry with clients in your state. That industry, which has royalties that have ranged between 2 and 5% has struggled because of foreign competition, cartels in Russia and Belarus and in Canada that have affected pricing, and you'd lose every single job if you had a higher royalty. And in fact, the government has offered royalty relief, which is something in my testimony I suggest you include. The government allows the companies to come in and ask for a reduced rate when the economics or unfair foreign competition affects them.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Tipton.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank the panel for taking time to be able to be here. Mr. Krebs, it was interesting listening to